Hey guys, so this is a weekend video. I'm making it because I need to make some videos for the weekend. Why? Because I work on Saturday and I don't want to make videos while I'm working. So I'm pre-making the video, but this is a pretty interesting video. This is a video on how Workhorse plans. It's not 100% official, but they plan to use their Lordstown facility to build the USP trucks. I don't know what I'm going to title the video, but I'm going to play this video and then I'll talk more about it. So let's begin.
Say anything about the post office. So let me say it this way, is that Union City certainly has the ability and the history that can meet really on any capacity level. And it's done 60,000 chassis, I think, in its history. So it does have that ability to do that. What I will say is that what we will look at is the capital we may have put in there from a standpoint of automate systems and the cost that we would have to do. And we would look at other areas and places that we could sub-assembly and subcontracting. And I think you mentioned earlier, lease first is Lordstown. And Lordstown's a great example of that, where it's a 6 million square foot facility that we would take a portion of that probably, and they could possibly do it at a lower cost than what we could do it for. So that's certainly something we would evaluate. Wayne might have more to kind of add here too.
Clearly, we have been evaluating that, and that's been part of our long-term strategy, at least understanding if and when it would be capable. But it goes beyond just the plan itself. It's also the technologies.
All right, guys, so there you go. Basically
use somebody's video to make this video. So yeah, as you can clearly see from that interview, they are assessing the facility, and there's a possibility that in the future, if they get the USP contract, they're going to need a bigger facility to basically produce all their cars. And of course, Donald Trump wants Lordstown to be filled up with employees because he wants to get it's part of his election campaign. So he's probably gonna pressure the US government to give Workhorse the USP deal, and then that is going to lead to more jobs created at Lordstown, the Lordstown facility. And the facility is pretty big. It's also solar energy supported. So that means that there's solar panels up and running in that facility. As we can see, it's already a facility that has already stuff in it. And GM paid an awesome deal for this facility. According to the balance sheet, I also have something proof too. According to the balance sheet, the land, building, and equipment is worth $20 million. And then, according to this article that I found, GM former plan Lordstown will be returning massive vehicle production, thousands of jobs. This was posted on May 22nd, 2020. And then we scroll further down, it says that GM sold the facility to Lordstown Motor, the plant, and the joint 5 peso of lands for $20 million, according to local records. So yeah, they paid $20 million for a six million feet facility that's already has equipment and already has equipment, and it's probably put billions of dollars into that facility already. And they got it for $20 million. You know how incredible that deal is? That's like a gold mine. It's like saying, I will give you $20, you will give me a facility that's worth billions of dollars. It's just such a good deal. I can't describe how much of a good deal this is, and Lordstown is probably going to benefit if Workhorse goes in and helps them with prepping the facility for more vehicle production. This facility is going to make a lot of money. It's going to create a lot of jobs, and Donald Trump really likes that. And that's why I think Lordstown. That's why I think Workhorse is going to win that USP deal. This is a video I'm going to play of the Lordstown facility. It's pretty nice. It's a pretty nice facility. Look how big that is. Look how big that facility is. This massive facility. Massive, massive facility. They even have solar panels. Like, these are solar panels that's powering the facility. That's incredible. So yeah, I mean, it probably uses a mix of electricity and solar power. They didn't pay for those solar panels. How much solar panels cost? That's expensive. Like, I muted the volume because I just want to talk while, you know, the showing off the facility. Look at all the machines and the robots. For $20 million, they got a wicked deal. Like a wicked deal. It's like saying, oh, you want this $6 million house for $200,000? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That's ridiculous. It's solar powered. It already has, like, you know, products and machinery that was worth billions of dollars, and they paid $20 million for this facility. It's just incredible. Look at that robot arm moving and demonstrating that, you know. I don't know. I just can't get over how good of a deal they got from this. I think this is like the painting room where they paint the car. I think so. I'm not 100% sure. They talk about it, but you know what? I'm gonna just let them talk about it, so I'm gonna play the video.
And then it gets assembled. It's mostly workers on a line, a moving line, very automated line, where every bolt is tracked. Every torque wrench, it's tracked, and it bubbles up to the servers. And that infrastructure and the total kind of man-machine interface that this machine of a plant has made, and for us to just reconfigure it, right? If we were to build this from scratch, it just wouldn't be possible. They aren't gonna make buildings like this again. And so we're taking it, we're reconfiguring it for our purposes, and we've been really pleased with the equipment here and the resources we've been able to find here. To produce a vehicle is not trivial, and no matter what kind of vehicle it is, it still has a steering wheel and seats and seat belts and airbags and doors, door handles and windows and windshields, and that takes to do that every time the same quality and to do it at a good economical price point takes a lot of automation and a lot of people. And this plant has been perfect for us. I'm Steve Burns. This is Lordstown Motors.
So yeah, as you can see, that facility for $20 million, this is like, I can't, like, if Diamond Peak Holding was like officially, like, I'm a shareholder, so they're gonna have to send me the documents for the merger between Diamond Peaks and Lordstown. And I think when I get that document, the stock's gonna fly to the moon. You know, that's what I think. Once I get that document for the voting between Diamond Peaks Holding and Lordstown, I think this stock's gonna take off, because everyone, all the other shareholders will get it too, and then they might dump more money into the stock, and that might pop the stock to the upside even further once those documents are official. So yeah, right now it's under pressure because of this whole investigation thingy, but I'm so bullish on this company. Workhorse, I think that's another reason why they don't want, they're suppressing the stock, because Workhorse would take off like no tomorrow if, you know, Diamond Peak Holdings took off, because then Workhorse's assets will look really nice on their balance sheet, because that, whatever value of Lordstown is, they get 10% of it. So if Lordstown was worth $10 billion, they get 10% of that, so they get $1 billion on their balance sheet. So that's just incredible, right? And you know, Cathie Wood backs this stock, so I wouldn't be too afraid of the stock going back to $2 or $3. But you never know, right? There's still that possibility, and you can lose hundreds of thousands of dollars depending on how much you invest in Workhorse. But if it does ever go back here, that could be an opportunity. I don't think it will unless the stock market crashes, then everything will go down. So it doesn't really matter at the end of the day. Anyways, this is it for my video. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe for future updates and have a great day. Bye.